Mark Victor Hansen has changed the world, one story at a time. Mark first gained international recognition and praise as one of the co-founding authors of the beloved and world record-breaking best-selling book series, Chicken Soup for the Soul. In addition to being hailed as one of the world's most wonderful speakers, Mark is an entrepreneur with a proven track record. He's built numerous successful businesses and is also co-creator of the groundbreaking wealth-generating book series, The 1 Minute Millionaire. Mark is America's ambassador of possibility. His wisdom is as good as gold. Made for Success is proud to present Mark Victor Hansen.
Hi, I'm Mark Victor Hansen, and welcome to Rip Roaring Wealth. The kind of wealth you can have as you expand your thinking, expand your ideas, and come from the end result of having a dream of your ideal, idyllic life. One that is smooth, happy, peaceful, calm, result-oriented, and totally philanthropic. In modern America, as well as most capitalist countries, anyone who has ambition, desire, and uses their practically limitless capacity for hard work and talent can turn their ideas into fortunes. And who doesn't dream of being a self-paid man or woman? George Getty worked his way to becoming a self-paid man by drilling 43 oil wells, of which 42 proved to be oil producers. George's road to wealth is history after that, considering that all that oil began to be the hot ticket item in 1904. George didn't believe in free handouts and made his son John Paul Getty work from the bottom up to attain his own wealth. John Paul Getty began as a roustabout apprentice, working his way to become a wildcatter and earning his first million by 1916, 1 year after he had started. Learning from an already proven expert in the field is the best way to become a self-made man or woman and learn everything about your business of choice. Even if you start by volunteering or working a free apprenticeship, you can only benefit from free hands-on knowledge of a mentor. The only course of action to follow such a thorough education is to go forth and conquer. J. Paul Getty didn't have two nickels to rub together, and his father wouldn't invest in his startup. So he approached a corporation to gain knowledge he needed. After attaining what most would consider a comfortable level of wealth, John Paul Getty wasn't satisfied and took a bigger step, learning Arabic to work directly with the world's richest oil sheiks, making him the number one oil expert of his time. When John Paul Getty passed away, he owned the controlling interest in over 200 companies, and his personal wealth was estimated at over $2 billion, considered the richest man in the world. John Paul Getty was a man of rip-roaring wealth. He also defined himself by collecting Greco-Roman artwork. And here in Los Angeles, we have the great Getty Museum. When he died, it was endowed with the most money of any museum ever, over $4 billion. If you haven't visited, I ask you to put it on your hit list because it will wow your soul. And you also want to go to his house in Malibu, which is right on Pacific Coast Highway, and it's a quaint little place that you want to go through the estate that he created because it just is exquisite, and it shows the outpicturing of what affluence can really be like with somebody living well. Let's define what a person of rip-roaring wealth looks like. A person with rip-roaring wealth uses their money to create, operate, and build businesses, enterprises, and even empires. Wealth is the ultimate ripple effect. It creates potential jobs for countless other people, spreading prosperity in vast new ways and giant proportions. Rip-roaring wealth allows you to have a whirl of fun and frolic. Theoretically, you could retire from having a lot of something to a whole bunch of nothing. Even if you hit the biggest oil well or diamond mine or gold mine, you must always come out playing a little, continuing to use your creativity, brilliance, and business acumen to hit fantastic heights of new possibilities. When you get closer to the horizon, it always expands. The same thing with rip-roaring wealth. Hopefully, you'll continue to build your business interest to increase employment, innovate goods, services, and ideas, and to benefit everyone and everything around you. I'm convinced the overall economic trend is up, despite all the alarms and fears plaguing our era. The world is on the threshold of the biggest and the most booming prosperity at any time in human history. Orient yourself toward the expression and expansion of steady growth. Constantly seek new ways and means to increase your output and the output of everything you own. Have large-scale projects, forever developing new products, services, and information. Use your imagination and energy to the benefit of everyone. There are always opportunities in both good times and bad times for the business person who will recognize, seize, and positively exploit them in a progressive, vigorous, and professional industrial commercial leadership way. The rewards awaiting you are practically limitless, and there's plenty of room at the top. So as Zig Ziglar says, we'll see you at the top. You know, the figurative Millionaires Club has unlimited vacancies in its membership roles. There have never been more of us, and if you're listening to this, it qualifies you as a future applicant. That is, if you're not already in our club. Building rip-roaring wealth and a substantial fortune isn't necessarily easy. However, building up your rip-roaring wealth can be fun if you pick a heartfelt desire and a passionate purposefulness as your work. Even extremely hard work can be enjoyable. It can be a means of making all your dreams tangible. Passion calls upon us at all the hours of the day and the week, and the years fly by. And the rewards are extraordinary at the finish line, and then you see a new, bigger, better finish line. Rip-roaring wealth is for the active dreamer who doesn't restrict him or herself with everyone else's work schedule. Rip-roaring wealth isn't the norm, and that means you can't be normal either. To become one of the greats, you must demand the utmost of excellence of yourself and a dedication of yourself as well as everyone else with whom you work. I've studied the lives of many great famous men and women and found that everything they became was from the many jobs that they had in hand, working with passion and enthusiasm, enthusiastic energy, and unbelievable, extraordinary hard work. Matter of fact, one man said the benefit of hard work is that you get more hard work to do. Their passionate dedication paid off, helping each one of these incredible people to achieve new levels of excellence and breakthrough thinking and results. They outthought, outworked, outled, outsold, outserved, outproduced all others, steadily climbing to the top of a rip-roaring mountain of wealth, and you can too. You know, during my lifelong climb up the mountain of rip-roaring wealth, I've found 10 principles that have proven to generate massive cash on my passions, and today I'm sharing them with you. In fact, sharing is one of the principles of wealth. Who would have thought? This program can be the starting point of your formal education and mentorship. Allow me at least here on this audio to be your mentor and you to be my mentee. I've had 44 superstar mentors, and I will give you everything they've given me as completely, clearly, and comprehensively as I can. You no longer have to wonder how you can become a prosperous person you are meant to be. These principles are going to lay the foundation to every profitable, ethical, moral, and enjoyable business enterprise you'll ever have. To cement these principles of rip-roaring wealth, I'm going to assign homework to you to complete if you so choose. Write each of these down today and keep them somewhere where you can see them every day. I keep my goals in my bathroom mirror so that I can see them when I first wake up, and it goes through the portal of my pupil into the depth of my soul and catalyzes me to get results beyond what you could ever expect. Remember, your rewards are going to keep traveling forward in front of you, and it's going to excite you. They've got to delight you. They've got to be bigger, because a lot of you will hit your goals in ready, step, fashion, and you got to have the next goal before you accomplish this goal. And never cross off your goal as you get it. Instead, I say get a purple pen, that's God's highest color, the top of the electromagnetic spectrum, and write down in lavender or purple next to it, victory. Because life is not a straight line. We learned in quantum physics There's particle and wave, and if there's waves in universe, there's ups and downs. And when you're down and in the valley, you want to be looking at the peak, and you want to tap yourself on the shoulder and say, attaboy, attagirl, you've achieved a lot of rip-roaring wealth, and you're going to achieve more. You know, when we wanted to make Chicken Soup for the Soul work, I interviewed the 101 best-selling authors. We had little yellow stickies on Jack's wall in Culver City. We ultimately put them in a little book called The Wow of a Business Plan. I recommend that to you. But we heard the mirror technique was so totally powerful that we had interviewed Scott Peck, who had made $40 million with The Road Less Traveled, 12 years number one. So we whited out his name, put in Chicken Soup for the Soul by Mark Victor Hansen and Dr. Jack Canfield, put it on my mirror, Jack's mirror, my office, Jack's office, and we surrounded it in Technicolor, because the more colorful it is, the clearer it is, because when you're born, your mind thinks in color. So you really want to go out of your way with this technique. It seems subtle. It seems simple. It seems unusual. People will make fun of you when they come in and they go to your bathroom and they see your goals where you shave or where you do your makeup. But I'm telling you, it works, because it goes, as I said, through the portal of the pupil into the depth of the soul. And when you got fixed your thought on your goal, the goal is yours. You progressively catch up to it. Okay, on to the 10 points. Number one way to accumulate rip-roaring wealth in the business world is, of course, own your own business. A beginning business owner should choose a field that they know, understand, like, love, respect, admire, and it should be the fulfillment of your dream come true. Obviously, one can't know everything they need to know in the beginning, and you have to have a solid knowledge of your chosen field or enterprise, and then be able to get the team, and team means together everyone accomplishes more, together. We'll talk about that in a second and another point, to build your enterprise. When I first stepped into the business world, I knew the industry of sales and people. I was an idea man, a social butterfly, and a top-notch salesman promoter. This didn't qualify me to get it done alone. Creating Chicken Soup for the Soul industry required the help of my partner, Jack Canfield, and many other experts in the field of publishing. What did we all have in common? Every one of us harbored the inner passion, dedication, determination, and a white-hot desire and hunger to learn from one another and work together in cooperative harmony, pursuing a goal bigger than ourselves. After 35 years in the business, I am today considered a world leader in writing, publishing, and marketing books. I hold the world record for having the most best-selling books, nonfiction, on a bestseller list at any given time, according to Guinness Book of Records. I am constantly updating my knowledge within an industry I'm passionate about, and it has led me up the mountain of rip-roaring success and wealth. Now, write down your passion. How can it become a business that has businesses, that employs people, that makes everybody better off and no one worse off? And may I make it even a bigger question and say, how can you wrap your business enterprises around the whole world to source and serve people that you'll never even know? I'm asking you to think bigger than you ever thought you could think. Now, make a clear picture in your mind, and if you can storyboard it, because your mind thinks in images. I say your imagination creates your reality. Put that picture on your mirror. Put it somewhere over your bed is what Jack Canfield did, of how much money you're going to make, what it looks like, what your vacations are going to be, what your home and stuff's going to be, because 5 years from now, you're going to have that. Now, here's the deal. The Danish poet laureate Kierkegaard said, great dreamers' dreams are never fulfilled. They're always transcended. You'll get more than you pay for. So make the picture big. Make it exciting. Make it complete as you can make it. Keep adding to it and not subtracting from it. And some of the goals you have, instead of 5 years, you'll have them in 1 year. Some of them you're going to have them in the next couple days. This is going to excite, titillate, and delight you. The reason this works is the law of attraction. The law of attraction has three little principles. Number one, you got to know what you want. Number two, universe only says yes. And number three, you've got to be in alignment with it. Your subconscious and conscious got to be alignment, and then it outpictures itself easily, effortlessly, and automatically. Major principle number two, rip-roaring wealth comes to those who understand that the aim of all business, enterprise, industry is to produce more and better goods, services, and information for people at an ever lower cost. This principle goes both ways. When something is more affordable, it can reach more people. And when you make it readily available to more people, it becomes more affordable. When you create an affordable and easily attained product, service, or piece of information, you will steadily expand your wealth. I invested in a Pulse Smart Pen. What is amazing to me is that the first ones prototypically were very expensive, about $200. As they passed the million sales, it went down to $139. When it gets to 10 million units sold, it goes down to under $50, and it's going to be the new computer pen that goes in everybody's hand, and it does a whole smorgasbord of things that is ever expanding because of new applications. That is the new enterprise. Think of it this way. The prosperity of a rock star depends on the growth and size of his or her audience. When a rock star first began his or her career, their music is usually more expensive and harder to find. Yet when the rock star puts his or her music on the social networking site, connects with people, and posts their songs as downloadable MP3s, not only does his or her audience grow, but the cost to produce the music drops steadily. In turn, the rock star's music is also more affordable and allows the audience to share and grow at an ever-accelerating rate. Why do you think that bulk shopping is so affordable and popular? Stores that sell items in bulk are the rock stars of their rip-roaring wealthy industry. Memorize this cycle of prosperity. More products and lower prices, more convenience equals more customers and more wealth for everyone. Ask yourself, how can my product, service, or information become the rock star that creates rip-roaring wealth industry? Think, is your heartfelt desire an already existing product? Write down 5 ways you can make your product, service, or information better than any of your competitors. Let me just give you one little example of that. Steve Jobs did that with iPod and put tape recorders and CD players relatively out of business in almost a nanosecond. They became the horse and buggy whip, the same as when Henry Ford created the automobile. They were basically useless. It was not a cyclical change, it was a structural change. And if you do a structural change, you will create rip-roaring wealth. Wherever you live, whoever you are, with education, without education, whether you're young or old, you can do something better than anyone has ever done it. I'm in my office having a meeting, and the director of first impressions come gushing in and says, look, we've got to interrupt this meeting. I said, look, we're busy. I got people from literally around the world, from Japan, Singapore. We're doing big business here. Said, no, I think you all want to see this. A young 17-year-old girl who is now in a book I wrote called The Richest Kids in America, How They Got That Way and You Can Too, brought in cupcakes and cookies with a logo design, and I think my foundation logo is as beautiful as any it exists. It is a butterfly, which is a symbol of universal illumination with the world inside. And this young lady, Allison Ames, had been getting up since 3 a.m. making culinary delights, started a company you can look at called WonderlandBakeries.com, and makes about $500,000 a month selling cupcakes and cookies with logo designs of companies to all the big companies around the world and selling them on the internet. Now, if you'd asked me if that was possible, I would have told you, no way. My daddy was a baker. Nobody can buy cupcakes or cookies online, but she did it. You know that those cupcakes are good when a future president of the United States hired her to make cupcakes to give out to everyone at the inaugural ball. This is rip-roaring wealth. It gave her fame, recognition, pay, renown, and utterly high respect for a young person. Point number 3. Rip-roaring wealth comes to those who have the essential sense of thrift. In my book, The 1 Minute Millionaire, I teach the 10-10-10-70 wealth equation. 10% of your wealth needs to go to giving. 10% of your wealth must be put into savings. 10% of your wealth should be invested. And you live on the other 70%. Rip-roaring wealth comes to those who practice disciplined economy wherever possible in their personal and business life affairs. The credo of the very rich is, make your money first, then think about spending it and circulating after it's accumulated. It's a best credo for the individual who wishes to have rip-roaring wealth and success. Benjamin Franklin was not only the wealthiest man of his time, but also an incredible innovator and creator of modern autobiography. The maxims Franklin left on his building wealth are still powerful today. The biggest of all was his policy on frugality. A penny saved is a penny earned, for industry pays debt, while despair increases it. Franklin understood and taught that you can't create wealth if you live beyond your means. Franklin didn't start rich, but he became rich with his diligent work, penny pinching, and creative thinking. Living the very principles he taught, Ben Franklin was rip-roaringly wealthy and urged everyone else to do the same. Do create a budget using the 10-10-10 equation, even if you have to start each one of the 10s at 0.25% and then go to 1%, 2%, build it up to 10%. Recognizing, of course, that you give 10%, save 10%, and invest 10%. Now, a lot of people say, well, my investment is my savings. No, no, no. Remember, we said quantum physics has wave propagation. And if it has wave propagations, there is going to be ups and downs in every business. There's going to be slow periods. There's going to be shutdowns. There's going to be shortages. There's going to be earthquakes. There's going to be weather outs. There's going to be all kinds of stuff. You need to have at least 8 months of earnings in savings for rainy day is what they call it. They call it your rainy day savings. What does that mean? That means if you're earning, and I'm going to do maybe a high number for you, $10,000 a month, you've got to have $80,000 stashed. So if you get fired or there's bad weather or your spouse or kids get sick, you can float through it. This is big stuff, but some of you have never heard it. You got to have a 10-10-10-70 equation. Write it out. Be very specific. Put it in your journal. Look at it with regularity. Now, you know, in our great country, the government is overspending and it's in too much debt because the people are overspending because we came up with a new thing called a credit card about 30 years ago and everyone thought they could have everything they want when they want it. The fact of the matter is, get on the right formula and you'll have a formula for success for the rest of your life. Principle number 4, rip-roaring opportunities for expansion should never be ignored or overlooked. On the other hand, one must always be on guard against the temptation to overexpand or launch expansion programs blindly without sufficient justification and planning. Forced growth can be fatal to any business, new or old, big or small. The easiest way to expand your business without risking the whole farm is to focus on your current customer base and adapt your business offerings to fit your customers' ever-changing needs, wants, and desires. You already have a great product, but what sets it apart from the pack? Figure out constantly and continuously how to make it unique, better, more unusual, and of greater service. Because Napoleon Hill said it so well, it's the quantity of service plus the quality of service with a positive mental attitude that equals unlimited compensation. Doesn't it tickle you when your significant other pays attention to the details when they make a meal for you? When they make that extraordinary, special, delightfully delicious meal for you. They choose your favorite wine, and they make it look aesthetically pleasing, and the aromas get you before you even get close. And then they grill that steak to tender perfection and light candles to make it special. It's all about the details. And we're talking about a physical eating meal, but we're talking about the meal called your business. And we're saying rip-roaring wealth is about making the experience, the journey, worthy of you. Now, just imagine that your customer base is that special someone you're making a meal for. Would having a twistable cap for that perfect Shiraz you produce make it more convenient for your buyers? Do you have multiple levels of products available for your customers? Having products at different price levels will ensure selling to more people and it can cost very little to differentiate it. Imagine yourself in your customer's shoes. What would you want from your product? Rip-roaring wealth is something an average person can have if they can assess and find extraordinarily simple solutions. Aha! Expansion doesn't have to have an increase in location and employees. What if it was just doubling your monthly sales? Write down three ways you can double your sales each and every month. Number five, rip-roaring wealth comes to those who run their own business, life, and affairs. A wise person would never expect an employee to do or think as well as he could him or herself. If they could, they would not be employees. A boss delegates responsibility, but he or she must maintain close supervision and authority over all the subordinates they trust with it. One stray match can burn down an entire forest, and one stray employee can bring down an entire company. Organize, keep your own calendar, take your family to dinner, and don't share the password to your computer with anyone. Trust me, you'll thank me later. Number six, rip-roaring wealth creators must always be on the lookout for new ways to improve products, services, and information to increase production and sales. During prosperous periods, techniques must be improved and costs lowered. In down periods, like Bill Marriott Jr., the creator of the Marriott chain with his father, you want to take advantage of lower costs in places where there will be tons of money later in good times. Mr. Marriott followed that principle when he bought and built hotels in spectacular locations, even though the economy was not at its best. When I was in Japan at the Ritz-Carlton, I had the good fortune to meet Mr. Bill Marriott and told him that I'd read his 1995 goal in the newspaper that he wanted to own 2,000 properties, he owned about 1,400 at the time, by the year 2000. This motivated me to invest in his company's stock. I also told him that I knew people with a proven track record like him never hit their goals but always exceeded them. In fact, by 2000, Mr. Marriott owned 2,500 hotels in the great Marriott trade, and he had just bought the Ritz-Carlton chain of hotels. Mr. Marriott replied and looked me in the eye, smiling, winking, and then he said, "You'll be happy to know, Mark, here in Japan, yesterday, I bought our 3,000th hotel." Seeing industry where everyone else is blinded by despair is the golden ticket to rip-roaring wealth again and again. Think. Innovation is a creation of simple solutions. Write down five problems that you're going to create the solution to and then find those solutions. Remember, seek and you shall find. Make the decision and your subconscious will make the provision. You are smarter, wiser, and more able than you think you are. Spiritual language says, greater is he or she that is in you than he or she that is in the world. Number seven, to create rip-roaring wealth, you have to be willing to take calculated risks with your own capital, credit, and borrowed money. W. Clement Stone taught me, borrow more than you need for longer than you need it, and then pay it back faster, and you'll have access to more funds than you can ever use. Note that nothing will write the finish to a career faster than a bad credit rating. Given the modern-day Google-like services, everyone can check your credit virtually, instantaneously, and you need to have your credit rating be impeccable, and may I recommend any employee you have check his or her credit rating. You want to have people working with you that are solvent, because insolvent people have a tendency to do some bad things, has been my experience. It's also important to note that the existence of risk creates profit and business success. So what is a calculated risk? A calculated risk is a decision in which the reward must be as much, but preferably greater than that which you stand to lose. Those who are successful at assessing the loss and reward ratio for their risk decisions become rip-roaringly wealthy in no time at all. How? Do you have multiple levels of products available to your customers? Write down a pyramid of products of the most affordable at the bottom, the most expensive at the top. Now, beside the different levels on the pyramid, write down how you would want to grow your company. Principle number 8, rip-roaring wealth creators must constantly seek new horizons, untapped, underexploited, and invisible niches and micro-niches, i.e. Google. Having traveled over 250,000 miles a year, speaking worldwide to over 250,000 people every year for the last 35 years, I know that people are eager to buy American products, services, information, and know-how. Today's rip-roaring wealth builder can cash in on foreign markets, both capitalistic, socialistic, and communistic. In my travels around the world, I've discovered that Europe is predominantly socialistic, or at least leaning that way. Russia and China are communistically capitalistic. In fact, when I've talked in Russia and China, you can see it and feel it and believe it. Because when I'm there, the people, the throngs, the crowds try to touch me, and I've got to have bodyguards keep them off because they want to touch a capitalist. They want to see if they can touch the hem of the garment and have it rub in. And my experience is, their personal truth is that they're very soon going to be real capitalists. Now, try to explore this e-commerce thought in the fastest, easiest way you can to create a global, electronic, digital business. Rip-roaring wealth is built quickly with confidence and volume when you have a reputation for standing behind your work, products, services, and information. Your guarantee should stand always to be honored. In doubtful cases, the decision should always be in the customer's favor. I recently had a client in the office, and he said the personal opinion was that the client didn't get what they wanted. He votes with the client and gives back the money when that happens. In Stu Leonard's grocery store chain in Connecticut, there's a sign in front of the stores that has 2 points on it. Number one, the customer is always right. Underneath that sign, number two says, if you don't remember number one, read it again and do it. A generous service policy should always be maintained. You want a reputation for complete reliability no matter how difficult it is to keep your promises. The size of your promise determines the size of your result. Stu Leonard always asked his customers what they wanted. And a lady came up to him and said, Stu, you keep the shopping carts outside, and when it rains, I got to put my baby in a diaper in there, and it soaks up the water, the baby cries, and it's a miserable shopping experience. Stu said, I never would have thought of that in 1,000 years. He immediately put an awning over the shopping carts and had dry, happy customers. Another lady came up to my friend Stu and said, Stu, you stack all the strawberries and put the big luscious ones on the top of the box and little ugly crushed ones in the bottom. I don't like it. He says, what do you want me to do? Lay them all out. Stu went to his board of directors. They said, are you crazy? People are only going to pick the good strawberries. He did that, and strawberry sales went up 350%. The customer is always right. The customer votes with his or her dollars. You need to let the customer vote in your favor. You need to guarantee your products and services so they get what they want, when they want, the way they want it. Number 10, rip-roaring wealth, no matter how much fortune you amass in business, should always be considered as a means of improving living conditions for everyone, everywhere, in every way. Rip-roaring wealth builders are responsible to their associates, partners, family, employees, stockholders, the public, and their philanthropies. As a rip-roaring wealth builder, believe me, you have limitless opportunities and potentials in you and around you, as long as you apply the rules of rip-roaring wealth and work with dedicated diligence and delight. Make it a joy of your heart to do your work. The world desperately needs alert, ambitious, able individuals who take low value and make it a high value to the marketplace, themselves, their family, the future, and create a fortune so that all that truly glitters can become gold. Now, write down your 5 top charities and decide that you're going to give 10% of your income to one charity a month, as an example. If you don't yet have the wealth to give, your time is worth it just the same. Write it down, make deliberate decisions to donate. And just like we do paper stock trades, you can do paper donation trades and simulate it in your mind, because the mind cannot tell the difference between imagination and reality. And as it impacts you, you're going to start having more opportunities, more ideas, more business ideas come to you, and better partners will show up automatically and axiomatically. Apply these principles consistently and persistently, and every day you're going to reap rewards in both a fulfilling life and ultimately and inevitably a big accumulated rip-roaring fortune. Now, it's important as we summarize. I want you to apply these. I want you to build yourself with biceps and triceps so you beat in your chest, so you feel like Tarzan or Tarzette, so you get excited as I am. Apply these principles consistently, insistently, and persistently, and every day you'll reap rewards of both a fulfilling life and an accumulating, rip-roaring future. All right, here they are, one more time. Number one, own your own business or businesses, plural. Two, create better products, services, and information than anyone else. Three, become intuitively thrifty. Use the 10-10-10-70 equation. Give 10, save 10, invest 10, and live on the other 70% as you build up to it moderately, progressively, and make that work in your life. Number four, keep your eyes open for expansion and choose your expansion plan carefully. Number five, run your own business, life, and affairs. You are the master of your fate, the captain of your soul. Six, improve your products, services, and information. Always keep your eyes open for industry growth opportunities. They are everywhere, always. Seven, take calculated risks to grow your business. Use a risk-reward ratio as the front end of your business practice. Eight, exploit new markets, niches, and micro-niches. Think globally, not just locally. Number nine, stand behind your product guarantees and warranties. And finally, number 10, always use part of your abundance to give back to others. Rip-roaring wealth is a circular cycle. You'll find a mentor to help you learn the process and a dedication of innovation and business. You'll strike up the path of the mountain to a rip-roaring wealth of your own. And when you reach the top, you begin to mentor others and give back to the community and world at large. If everyone in America and the world learned this cycle, poverty would become non-existent. Muhammad Yunus says poverty should exist in one place and one place only, a museum. Abundance is within your mind. Abundance is within your grasp. All you have to do is go inside and manifest it outside. Ladies and gentlemen, we've covered a great deal of phenomenal information that's going to give you rip-roaring wealth. But the difference between whether you do or whether you don't is whether you change your mind and permanentize this thinking into your head. It takes spaced repetition learning. Your mother would shout at you, "Don't slam the door." She said it hundreds of times. I'm asking you to make a decision in favor of yourself, to listen to these tapes again and again and again, and take a do it now attitude. Say to yourself 50 times a day, do it now, do it now, do it now. And you'll apply do it now to each and every one of these 10 principles. And you're going to start having self-reliance to action. You're going to be the implementer. You're going to be the result getter. And people are going to look at you in a new fond light. If you become a do it now person, you're going to have rip-roaring wealth.
You've been learning from Mark Victor Hansen, America's ambassador of possibility. See Mark's appearance schedule and get access to a powerful range of free audio and video downloads. Visit www.markvictorhansen.com. To bring Mark's 30 years of wealth creating experience to your stage or boardroom, call toll-free 800-433-2314. That's 800-433-2314. On behalf of Mark Victor Hansen and Made for Success, we wish you rip-roaring wealth.